Caraca!
Let's start from the beginning. I think it was 1978. It was a store in Stockholm, Sweden. That's where I'm from. I saw one hanging on the wall in the store, and I said, oh, that's really kind of cool. I didn't have the money for it at the time, you know. And I said I wanted it, but it wasn't there when I had the money for it. And a couple of weeks later or so, I was auditioning a drummer, and he came in, and on the phone he told me he was actually a guitar player, not a drummer. I didn't need a drummer, so I said, hey, come on down anyway, bring your guitar. She brought the guitar. I said, I like your guitar, gonna sell it. And I don't know, you know. So anyway, I bought it from him for about $200. And that was a long, long time ago. And this is the very guitar here. And it became our favorite guitar for years and years and years. This was the guitar I brought with me to America. Just this guitar, an extra pair of pants, and it didn't have quite as many marks on it at the time.
When we get to do something as special as this, to do something to pay tribute to the artists who play our products, it's very rewarding.
In all its greatness, the long-awaited Yngwie Malmsteen Play Loud. Because of this.
Yeah, this was something I put on there, I think during the first Rising Force album. It came from a cassette tape somebody had left. They had a sticker that said Play Loud on it. I said, oh, pretty cool, I'll take that. And I put it on.
A project like this is very challenging. Trying to nail all the details with an exact replica, it's not an easy thing to do. There's just so much involved in this guitar.
Yeah, the louder the instrument is, the better it's gonna sound when it's plugged in.
Yeah.
I got an idea though. Hey, yeah, let's clamp the string right here. That's good for the fucking
tone. And you cut it off.
It's good for the tone in it. This makes sense, right?
I start thinking about the guitar, what it's been through.
And I think this is from biting, actually. This is from biting. In fact, I know it is.
The most difficult part is usually how I'm gonna replicate, you know, specific wears and stuff on the guitar, or burns or breakage or whatever.
It does have a lot of scratches on it. And it's missing a screw right here. Should I do the honors?
Please.
This is extreme. Okay? Here we go. Oh my God. He's even got the big screw. No way. This is no way. The switch is bent the same way. The crack. I'm completely speechless. Completely blown away. This is just absolutely ridiculous. This is like, I mean, I don't have words. You know, it's sick. I don't know what to say, but it's completely blown away. Yeah, I scalloped this myself.
Skeleton kind of lights.
I always wanted to have a guitar that was the cream white with a maple neck.
That's me playing the cymbals with the guitar, like this.
How could you make the cracks the same?
This stick you hear.
I think I put on there 82, no 83, I think it was 84. This type of gear with a big headstock, and that's the basis of all my guitars.
There's nothing not right. Completely, utterly stunning.
Cool.
No, it's beyond cool, man.
Stratocaster is like a part of me, you know, like it's just like everything is just right on it.